Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you in this video lecture on Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is Module 5, Properties of Steam. And lecture number 501, this is the first lecture on the properties of steam. So we recap from the previous lecture. So previous four module, we discussed the zeroth law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, and the application of first law of thermodynamics to the open system, closed system, and we solved problems on the steady flow energy equation and various thermodynamic properties, and we studied the second law of thermodynamics. We studied about the heat engine, refrigerator, heat pump, and entropy and entropy calculation for various process. So the first three laws, zeroth law, first law and second law of thermodynamics, we studied earlier. Now here in this topic, properties of steam, so we will be studying about the formation of steam and its thermodynamic properties, use of steam table and Mollier chart, and determination of dryness fraction of the steam. So, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define steam and its properties. That is the learning outcome for this lecture. So, the pure substance. So, the steam is known as pure substance. We will see what is a pure substance and what are the examples for pure substance. A substance of constant chemical composition throughout its mass is called as pure substance. So every substance has got the chemical composition. For example, sodium Na, sodium chloride NaCl, potassium potassium oxide KOH, nitrogen oxide NO2. So every substance has got some chemical composition throughout its mass is called Every substance they have some chemical composition. So a substance of constant chemical composition throughout its mass is called as pure substance. Water is an example of pure substance. So it may exist in any one of the three forms, namely solid form ice, liquid form water, and gaseous form water vapor or steam. Or it may coexist in two forms. Why water is called as pure substance? In all the three forms, the molecular formula is H2O, and it does not undergo any chemical reaction during the phase transformation. So in all the three forms of the substance, the chemical formula is the same. So then it is called as a pure substance. So chemical composition throughout its mass, whatever may be the form, solid form, liquid form, or the gaseous form. The steam is very popular in power generation using the steam power plant. So the steam power plant, steam engine, they are using the steam to produce the power. So in olden days, earlier days, so we first invented only the steam turbine to produce the steam engine, then the steam turbine to produce the mechanical power. Other examples of pure substance are nitrogen, carbon dioxide, argon, air, and oxygen. Now look at the diagram. So we have a piston cylinder arrangement. So initially we have water at 0 degrees Celsius. The piston will freely reciprocate in the cylinder, and we have a weight to maintain the position of the piston in right position, and the heat is supplied. Now initially we have water at 0 degrees Celsius. So inside the cylinder we maintain the atmospheric pressure. In all the cylinders, the pressure is maintained at atmospheric condition, and heat is continuously added. So initially, first diagram, we have water at 0 degrees Celsius, and when you add the heat energy, the water temperature is increasing. At a particular condition, particular point, the water temperature will become saturation temperature TS. Then when the water reaches the saturation condition, when you add further heat energy, the water starts to evaporate. So the evaporate, it is converted into water vapor or steam. Now we look at this next diagram. So So the water quality is decreasing and you may find the wet steam above the top of the water. And when you further continuously add heat energy, water is keep on evaporating, and at a particular point you have only steam inside the chamber, only inside the cylinder, and this steam is called as dry saturated steam. Then further you are heating, then the temperature of the steam is increasing, then it is called as superheated steam. So the water at 0 degree Celsius, on heating it reaches the saturation temperature, and further heating it is converted into steam. Initially it is wet steam, so wet steam contains water particle, and the further heating it becomes dry saturated steam, and then after dry saturated condition, when you further heat the steam, that becomes superheated steam. And we try to plot the variation of properties in a diagram. Amount of heat added in the x-axis and temperature in the y-axis, and we have the line, it is at constant pressure, atmospheric pressure. So throughout the line, blue color line, the property, the pressure is atmospheric pressure. And instead of 0 degree Celsius, we take minus 10 degree Celsius. So minus 10 degree Celsius, it is ice. So we start from ice at minus 10 degree Celsius. First it is heated. So you add the heat energy. When you move in this direction, it is heated. Temperature is increasing at the point B. So point A is here, minus 10 degree Celsius. Point B is 0 degree Celsius. And in between A to B, the temperature of the ice is increasing. And this is the amount of heat added between A and B is called as sensible heat of ice. So the heat is added is used to increase the temperature of the ice from minus 10 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius. But still it remains only in the solid form. It is only in the form of ice. Now this is saturated liquid, saturated ice, 0 degree Celsius. And further you are adding heat energy. So remember, the pressure is constant throughout the line. Now the temperature is also constant. So the temperature in the line BC equal to 0 degree Celsius. Now the ice melts and it is converted into water. So here at the point B, it is ice at 0 degree Celsius. So when you move in this direction, the quantity of ice decreases, water starts to form. And here it is completely water at 0 degree Celsius. And the amount of heat added between B and C, it is called as latent heat of fusion. So latent heat is for change of form. So the change of one form to another form, liquid form to vapor form, or solid form to liquid form. Now at the point C, it is completely water at 0 degree Celsius. Now further you are adding heat energy, so the water temperature increases, so up to the point D where the temperature is 100 degree Celsius. So water at 0 degree Celsius, so here again it is water at 100 degree Celsius. So the amount of heat added between C and D, it is called as sensible heat of water. Then, so here point D, it is completely water at the saturated condition, so at atmospheric pressure. So 100 degree Celsius is the saturation temperature. So when you heat the water further, the water starts to evaporate. So D to E, it is evaporation process. So here it is completely water at 100 degree Celsius. So here it is completely vapor at 100 degree Celsius. So the point E is called as dry saturated vapor. Point D is called as saturated liquid. And the amount of heat added between D and E, it is called as latent heat of evaporation. Then point E, it is completely vapor. It is called as dry saturated vapor. And when you add heat, when you add heat further to the steam, that is called as superheating process. So the amount of heat added between E and F, it is superheating of steam. So these are all the four stages. First stage, second stage, third stage, fourth stage, fifth stage of the steam formation. And here B to C, the process is called as fusion or melting. D to E is called as evaporation. And U to F is called as superheating of vapor. Now, we have different terminology in the formation of the steam. So, we will define all the terminology in the next, in the subsequent slides. Stage AB. So, ice is heated from minus 10 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius. The ice is in the solid form and the temperature of the ice increases. The heat added to change the temperature of ice at constant pressure is called as sensible heat of ice. So, this is the term, this is the terminology that you have to remember, sensible heat of ice. So, the amount of heat added to change the temperature of ice at a constant pressure is called as sensible heat of ice. And the stage between B and C, the state B is saturation point of ice or melting point, and the corresponding temperature is called as melting or fusion temperature. So, when you heat further after the melting point or melting temperature, it starts to melt. So, when heat added beyond the melting point at constant pressure, the ice starts to melt and it becomes water. So, during the heat addition from B to C, the amount of water increases and the amount of ice decreases. At the point C, it is completely water at 0 degrees Celsius and 1 atmospheric pressure. So, the heat added to convert unit mass of ice from saturation temperature into water at constant pressure and temperature is called as latent heat of fusion. So, here you have one topic, latent heat of fusion. How will you define the latent heat of fusion? The amount of heat added to convert unit mass of ice from saturation temperature into water at a constant pressure and temperature is called as latent heat of fusion. The reverse of the process is called as freezing, latent heat of freezing. So, converting ice into water is fusion, and converting water into ice is called as freezing. Then stage C to D, the water at 0 degrees Celsius is heated to raise the temperature at 100 degrees Celsius at 1 atmospheric pressure. So, the amount of heat added to raise the temperature of water at the constant pressure is called as sensible heat of water. So, this is again important term, sensible heat of water. Then stage D to E, the state D is saturation point of water and the corresponding temperature is called as saturation temperature of water or boiling temperature. So, when the heat is added beyond the saturation temperature of water, the water starts to vaporize while the temperature and the pressure remains constant. So, during this stage, the mixture of water and the water vapor coexist in the cylinder. So, this is important stage for all our further discussion. So, formation of wet steam. The amount of heat added at the constant pressure and temperature to convert unit mass of water at the saturation temperature completely into steam is called as latent heat of vaporization. So, this latent heat of vaporization is also important parameter for all our discussion further. Then stage E to F, the E is the known as dry saturated steam. When heat is added beyond the dry saturated condition, it becomes superheated steam. The amount of heat added to convert dry saturated steam into superheated steam is called as heat of superheat. So, this is another parameter, heat of superheat in the formation of the steam. So, we have explained all the 5 stages. So, A to B, B to C, so A to B, B to C, C to D, and D to E and E to F. Now, we discuss the terminologies related with the formation of steam. The first parameter is sensible heat of ice. So, we recall from our earlier discussion, the amount of heat required per unit mass of ice to raise its temperature from given temperature to saturation temperature or melting point at a constant pressure is called a sensible heat of ice. So, it is in the solid form. But the amount of heat required to convert into from any temperature to the saturation temperature is called as a sensible heat of ice. And melting or fusion temperature, the temperature at which ice starts to melt at constant pressure is called as melting temperature of ice. The amount of at atmospheric pressure, the melting or fusion temperature is 0 degree Celsius. And latent heat of fusion, the amount of heat required to completely convert unit mass of ice from and at the saturation temperature into water at the constant pressure is called as latent heat of fusion. So, the amount of heat required to convert 1 kg of ice from saturation temperature to completely water at the constant pressure. So, the reverse of the process is called as solidification or freezing. And freezing or solidification temperature, the temperature at which the water starts to become ice on cooling at the constant pressure is called as freezing or solidification temperature. So, freezing temperature or the reverse of the melting is called as solidification and solidification temperature. Then, sensible heat of water, the amount of heat required to heat water at constant pressure from a given temperature to its saturation temperature is called as sensible heat of water. And the boiling temperature, the temperature at which the water starts to vaporize at a given pressure is called as boiling temperature. So, at atmospheric pressure, the boiling temperature is 100 degree Celsius. So, this is very commonly known to everybody. So, the atmospheric pressure at 100 degree Celsius, the water is converted into vapor. Even at open pan, when you heat the water starts to evaporate at 100 degree Celsius. And the latter heat of vaporization, the amount of heat required to completely convert unit mass of water from and at saturation temperature into steam at constant pressure is called as latent heat of vaporization. The reverse process is called as condensation. Then subcooled or compressed water. The water at a temperature less than the saturation temperature at a given pressure is called as subcooled or compressed water. Then wet steam. The mixture of steam and water particle is called as wet steam. The quality of the wet steam is given by the drainage fraction X. So, X equal to Mg divided by Mg plus Mf, where Mg is the mass of the dry steam and the Mf is the mass of the water particle present in the wet steam. And dry saturated steam, the steam without any water particle is called as dry saturated steam. And the superheated steam, when the steam is heated beyond the dry saturated condition, then the steam is called as superheated steam. The steam available above its saturation temperature is called as superheated steam. The temperature of superheated steam is denoted by T, which is always greater than the saturation temperature TS. So, TS is the saturation temperature and T is the temperature of the superheated steam. And we have one more parameter, degree of superheat. The temperature difference between superheated temperature and the saturation temperature is called as degree of superheat. This is very important parameter. So, degree of superheat equal to T minus TS. So, T is the temperature of the superheated steam and TS is the saturation temperature. And the heat of superheat, the amount of heat required to convert unit mass of dry saturated steam into superheated steam at the given pressure, at constant pressure is called as heat of superheat. So, heat of superheat equal to Cp into T minus TS, where Cp is the specific heat of the steam, which is normally taken as 2.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And how to calculate the properties of steam? So, the first we take the terminologies. P is the saturation pressure, either bar or club Pascal. TS is the saturation temperature in Kelvin. T is the temperature of superheated steam in Kelvin. Vf is the specific volume of the saturated water meter cube per kilogram. Vg is the specific volume of saturated steam meter cube per kilogram. Hf is the sensible heat of water kilojoules per kilogram. Hfg is the latent heat of vaporization in kilojoules per kilogram. Hg is the specific enthalpy of saturated steam kilojoules per kilogram. Sf is the specific entropy of saturated water kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Sfg is the specific entropy of vaporization kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And Sg equal to specific entropy of saturated steam kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. X is the drainage fraction. Cp is the specific heat of superheated steam in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the suffix F stands for fluid. So, here we find FG. So, F stands for water, G stands for gaseous phase or steam, and FG, it is a conversion of liquid phase to gaseous phase. So, these are all the terminologies that you have to remember. And we calculate the properties. We require the properties. So, all the properties, we have one table called a steam table. So, using the steam table, we can take the properties. I will explain at the end of the lecture, I will explain how to use the steam table for taking the parameter and calculate various properties of the steam. And the first property is specific volume. So, we have three different types of steam, wet steam, dry steam and the superheated steam. And the wet steam contains water particle, dry steam, it is only with the water vapor, there is no water particle, and superheated steam, and the steam beyond the dry saturated steam, temperature of the dry saturated steam. So, for wet steam, V wet equal to 1 minus X into Vf plus X into Vg. So, Vf is the specific volume of the liquid and Vg is the specific volume of the steam. X is the dryness fraction. So, for dry steam, V dry equal to Vg and superheated steam, V super equal to Vg into T by Ts. So here the Vf, Vg and the Ts, all these values are taken from the steam table, and the T is the temperature of the superheated steam. And the specific enthalpy of the steam, wet steam, H1T equal to Hf plus X into Hfg, H dry steam equal to H dry equal to Hg, and superheated steam, H super equal to Hg plus Cp into T minus Ts. And again Hfg, Hf, Hg value, they are all taken from the steam table. And the specific entropy of the steam, so V wet steam, S wet equal to Sf plus X into Hfg, dry steam, S dry equal to Sg, and for superheated steam, S super equal to Sg plus Cp into logarithmic of T by Ts. So T is the temperature of the superheated steam, Ts is the saturation temperature. So here again Sf, Sfg and Sg value, they are taken from the steam table. And the specific internal energy, that we have to calculate from the previous equations, we have to calculate. So for wet steam, U wet equal to H wet minus P into V wet. So H equal to U plus PV. So from that equation, U equal to H minus P into V. So for dry steam, U dry equal to Hg minus P into Vg. And for superheated steam, U super equal to H super minus P into V super. So these are all the four important properties in the properties of the steam, which is required for our calculation. And this is the steam table I mentioned earlier, which we have to use for all our property calculation. And this steam table is permitted in the university examination, so you can use it for taking the properties. So here we have five tables. So table number one, it is based on the, all the properties are based on the temperature, saturated water and the steam temperature table. So if you look at the first column, it is saturation temperature, and the second column absolute pressure. So for this temperature, what is the absolute pressure? Then the specific volume, we have the water Vf, steam Vg, and specific enthalpy in kilojoules per kilogram, water Hf, evaporation Hfg, and the steam Hg, and the specific entropy kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, water Sf, evaporation Sfg, and steam Sg. And the table will continue up to the critical pressure 221.2 bar. So I have taken only the first page of the table. All the properties are available for various pressures up to various temperature up to 524 degree Celsius. Now, so for a given temperature, for example, you are given 10 degree Celsius. Now you horizontally you have to read the properties. So pressure is 0.01227 bar. Volume Vf equal to 0.00100 and Vg equal to 106.43. All these values that you have to read. Similarly, for all the temperature, whatever the temperature, you have to take the properties from this table. And table number 2, it is based on this, the same properties with based on the pressure. So, saturated water and the steam table, pressure table. So, this table we will be using. So, absolute pressure, first column is absolute pressure and the second column is the corresponding saturation temperature. For example, 0.1 bar, the saturation temperature is 45.8 degree Celsius. So, all the properties, the same properties are available here. Pressure, temperature, Vf, Vg, Hf, Hfg, Hg, V, Sf, Sfg and Sg values are available. For a given pressure, you can horizontally read the parameter. So, this is the table number 2. Table number 4 is saturation specific enthalpy of superheated steam. So, for superheated steam, we have to refer three tables. So, for specific enthalpy, specific entropy and specific volume, we have to refer separate table. So, this is the specific enthalpy table of the superheated steam, and the first column is the absolute pressure, second column is the saturation temperature, and here you are given the temperature. This is the temperature of the superheated steam. Say, for example, 1 bar 200 degree Celsius, you can read the value. 1 bar 200 degree Celsius, you can read the value 2875.4 kilojoules per kilogram. So, for the given pressure and temperature, we can take the specific enthalpy of superheated steam. And this is table number 5, this is specific entropy of superheated steam. So, this again the same pattern. So, the first column is pressure. Second column is saturation temperature. Horizontally, you are given the temperature of the superheated steam. For a given pressure and temperature of the superheated steam, we can take the specific entropy. This is table number 5. And table number 3 is the specific volume of the superheated steam. So this you can use to calculate the, to find out the specific volume of the superheated steam. Again, the first column is pressure, and horizontally we have different temperature of the superheated steam. So for a given pressure and temperature, you can take the specific volume. So for superheated steam, you have to refer 3 tables. Specific volume, table number 3. Specific entropy, table number 5. Specific enthalpy, table number 4. And for dry saturated or the wet steam, you can refer to the table number 2 with respect to pressure and table number 1 with respect to temperature. So, taking the properties and using the equations given here, you can calculate the properties of the steam. So, that is this is very simple calculation, simple arithmetic calculation. You have to take the properties carefully and you have to calculate the value. One important point, sometimes we have to interpolate. For example, you are given 15.5 degrees Celsius, then we have to take the interpolate. By linear interpolation, we have to take the value in between. That we will see in the examples. And this is the Mollier diagram attached to the steam table. This table, all the properties, whatever we mentioned earlier, that is given graphically here. And in the x-axis, we have the specific entropy. Y-axis, we have the specific enthalpy. And we have different lines. So, the dark line, the final line, curve line is called a saturated vapor line. And above the saturated vapor line, we have the superheated steam. Below the saturated vapor line, we have the wet steam. And you have the constant pressure lines are available here. Constant temperature lines are available here. So, below the saturation line, we have the constant dryness fraction line. So, here we have specific entropy on the x-axis, specific enthalpy on the y-axis, saturation line here, pressure in bar, temperature in degree Celsius, and dryness fraction is also given. And the specific volume is also available in the Mollier diagram. All the properties are available in the graphical form. Majority of the cases, in all the problems, we refer only the steam table, which is easy. So, if it is mentioned in the problem, use the Mollier diagram to solve the problem, then we have to refer to the Mollier diagram, and we will solve problems using the steam table as well as Mollier diagram in the subsequent lectures. So, we have a reflection spot. So, from the discussion for the past 25 minutes, so based on our observation, you write down the terms that you remember from the lecture. You take few seconds and write down the terms. Write down whatever you remember from the, whatever the point title you remember from the lecture. You take a few seconds, you take a paper and pencil and write down. So, if you mentioned all the points I have shown here, then you are, you observed the lecture very well. So, pure substance, sensible heat of ice, subcooled water, melting and fusion, latent heat of melting, sensible heat of water, melting temperature, boiling temperature, saturation temperature, latent heat of evaporation, superheating, degree of superheat, heat of superheat, wet steam, dry saturated steam, superheated steam, Mollier diagram, saturation temperature. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. So, thank you for watching. We'll meet again.